some people over there, that's where it's from. Some people over there, right, in the purple and gold, they only, no. The people over there in the brown, they only deal with purple and gold, IURC. They still call them Hell Zeus, but they have a Hebrew name, right? The father and the son name is in a Paleo Hebrew, right? They don't deal with the mark of the beast. They say the mark of the beast is Christianity. They believe that the mark of the beast is not here. But the mark of the beast is the RFID chip that real soon, these devils, the so-called white men, the Bacon Elite family, will try to make that the world currency to put in your hand.
That's what I'm saying, because look, I read Revelation.
That's right.
I know my father's doctrine. So I know that.
There, go right here.
Right here.
That's just false religion. So it's different spiritual cultures.
Yep.
And when you know the true spirit, God gives you discernment. Everything is appointed. My God, the God of God is the God of organization. Everything is in order.
That's right, brother.
And
that's
appointed.
Right.
So, you know, that's why, you know, I'm listening.
That's right, brother.
I'm not just here for no reason.
Yeah, that's right.
Know? And I thank you for allowing me to write notes.
You cool, brother. You cool, man. I pray that you won the elect. You know what I mean? And that's what I want. I pray that you won the elect, so that way, if something happened to any of us, it'd be somebody on this earth that took what we saying seriously, and then you'll be on this earth to teach this word too. Our job is to get you to be the prophet that you were back in those days, when we were called this. Before we became this, our job is to remind you of where you come from and to get you there, though, in these days. Because we're still on that same earth. We're still on that same earth as old times. So that means God never changed. Only thing changed is these damn people. That's it. The God, even their idols never changed. They still got the same idols.
They do.
They still got the same idols. You know?
Right.
Go ahead. I'm just vibing, you know, building with
it.
Yahweh and Yahweh Shah, all right? Go back to that moment. Romans 10 and 15. In hell shall they preach, except they be sent.
So how should they preach except they be sent, right? Moses, Paul, all of them were sent through the Spirit, all right? So at the, reincarnation is real, all right? Because the prophets are subject unto the prophets. Now, the prophets are going to come back in this time and teach the Father, Heavenly Father, and the Son's true name. Teach our people back to their inheritance, who they are, all right? To turn back to the Heavenly Father, all right? To call on the Lord's true name, all right? Because you're giving up the wrong vibration, trying to talk to the Heavenly Father and the Son. You're not calling their proper name. He's not listening.
Right, and it's only set up for the elect to know that name. It's something that's predestined from the beginning.
Alright,
this is Jeremiah, chapter 3, verse 15. And I will give you pastors according to my heart.
So the Lord says he's going to give you pastors according to his heart. Alright, keep going.
We shall feed you with knowledge and understanding.
Alright, we shall feed you knowledge and understanding. Alright, because what the Lord said, my people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. Knowledge of what? Knowledge of that they knowing that they are the children of Israel. Alright, knowledge of the Heavenly Father, true name, Yahweh, Yahweh Shah. Alright, because our people are spiritually lost. They're in a spiritually Gentile state of mind. They may have talked about every wind of doctrine. So the Lord raised up his prophets again, and this time, to teach his people sincerely, the elect. Because only the elect is going to receive the message.
Alright, this is Acts 2 and 20. For the sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before that great and notable day of the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Alright? Ye men of Israel, hear these words.
Ye men of Israel. Because real soon it's going to be a famine of the word. Alright? Alright, and the ones that gonna have the knowledge and the understanding, alright, of knowing that we are the children of Israel and the Father's true name, which is the elect, in the day of trouble, gonna call on the name of the Lord. Alright? So it's very important that our people hearken unto the men of the Lord right now, man. Hearken unto his servant, hearken unto his prophet. Alright?
This is Romans 10 and 13. For whosoever should call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
And it just said it in Acts. So Paul saying it again in Romans. All right, keep going.
How then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed?
All right, so our people haven't believed on Yahweh, Yahweh Shah. Our people was told Jesus and Jehovah. All right, when the letter J did not exist. All right, because we the real children of Israel. We the chosen on this earth. We're not African. All right, we're not no Negroes, man. All right, we are the children of Israel. All right, keep going.
In hell shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard.
So the Lord talking to you Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans. All right? That y'all need to call on the Heavenly Father true name, Yahweh, and the Son's name, Yahweh Shah, to repent,
right.
To turn back.
Right. And check this out. How can they call on him when they haven't been exposed to him yet?
Come.
They're going to expose you again, right?
They don't have the true name.
Unity. We can't have unity with her. of us is sexual. I can't have unity with her. We're not going to agree to things. I can't have unity with that brother down there walking the street. Why? Because we walk far enough to come down to us eat some pork. I don't eat pork.
I got a pretty
good. Now I come down there to celebrate holidays. He celebrate holidays. I don't. He come down to us sitting in the boat. He calling on Jesus. I'm going to kick him out the boat. I call on Yahweh Jah. So there's no unity.
I got
you see what I'm saying? We thought chicken would be. You know? But that's the unity that you want right here.
I'm saying the unity is our brother through Christ, you know.
Through the Messiah, yeah.
Yeah, through our
now
Messiah.
Now this is unity.
That's what I'm saying.
But how much is going to, how there's a set number to who's going to be united. Revelation 7, real quick, photo.
All right.
But Michael Shine Brothers.
All right.
This is the set number that you're looking for. United, everybody else is gonna perish, bro. Cause they got their mind stuck in the world.
This is Revelation chapter 7, verse 1.
That's all we're looking for, right?
And after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth, that the wind should not blow on the earth nor on the sea.
Right. You see all the destruction happening overseas and all these different places, but it hasn't come here yet. That's because the Lord keeping it away. He keeping it from coming to America. How is he doing that? He hasn't put the thoughts into the minds of Putin, Kim Jong-un, and all these foreign nations. You know, Trump. He hasn't put the thoughts into their mind yet to complete his plan. When he does that, it's over. But when is he going to do it? He's not going to allow World War III to break out yet. Until, brother, like, you wake up, then we get the next brother, and the next brother. We get 144,000. And then one third of the men, women, and children. We out of here, man. We'll be ruling. We had them in slavery. Well, not him. We had them in slavery. Right now, bro, that's what he's waiting on. That shit can happen today, but our people don't want to wake the hell up. They want to celebrate Memorial Day in 2018. World War III at the door, they still celebrate Memorial Day. You get what I'm saying? They still celebrate Halloween. God. You get what I'm saying, man? Go ahead, bro.
It says, "Thorn on any tree." And I saw another angel ascending from the east, having the seal of the living power. And he cried with a loud voice before angels to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea, saying, "Hurt not the earth, neither the sea, nor the trees, until we have sealed the servants of our God in their forehead."
Right. So that's what we're doing right now, sealing you up, or hopefully you. Right? We seal. Right? That, what that means is you get a mark of exemption to be sealed to the truth.
This is Ezekiel 9:4. And the Lord said unto him, "Go through the midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem, and set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and that cry for all the abominations that be done in the midst thereof."
Right, you got different versions of the word mark. You got a person named Mark, you got a mark you can shoot at, you got a mark you can write on your arm, you know what I'm saying? So we know that mark is talking about the mark of the beast, Arvaditcha, Karagma in the Greek. But then you got another word, mark, which means exemption from judgment. So he said, go around, ignore him. See that? The angel's like, yeah, him, send him that way, send the next brother that way, send him that way. He just joined.
This brother right here? This brother new?
Look at this. Oh, no, that's devil.
No, this devil.
That's devil, trust me.
That's love.
That's devil. You just don't know.
I know sign language.
I know, but sign
language.
I know, brother, I know.
Yeah.
I'm completely with you.
But this love.
It's the devil, bro.
This the devil.
I agree, but check me out. Where the sign language come from? Check it out and look into it. You're gonna see where that symbol. It didn't have to be that. They could have made it anything. You feel what I'm saying to you? But they chose that. That comes from the devil. That's called the mano conorto, which is the horn hand. I understand, because my daughter, we teach her sign language at the house. And when that come up, she's like, but it means love. I'm like, you're right. But where it comes from, you feel me? You gotta understand that. I told my daughter, I said, yo, understand where it comes from, but still do that for love.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But understand where it comes from, though. Don't lie to yourself about it. You know what I mean? So, but I get where you coming from. That was sincere. You saying, yo, that's love, bro. You know? So, go ahead.
It says, and I heard the number of them which were sealed, and they were sealed 144,000 of all the tribes of the
right? So only 144,000 men are going to wake up to this truth today. And then the women and children, they're going to just fall in line. Women fall in line with whatever's in authority. That's just it. They fall in line with the white man right now. You know what I mean? They fall in line with them is they can kick you out the house. They can do welfare, child support. Women can have sex with multiple men. That's against the scriptures. A man trying to put his woman in place, they go to jail. So what does that mean? You ain't got no power. Ain't that fucked up?
Adultery.
Adultery.
Fornication.
That's right, brother. So that means we really don't have no power in this society. But these niggas walking around like they proud. Walk around, grill you down like they about to do something to you. Right? They ain't got no goddamn power. You getting power. We got power. Because I'll fight you with this word.
Exactly.
And I'll defeat these damn fools.
That's sharpening it.
That's sharpening it too. That's what. Go ahead, brother.
All right. And like the elder was saying, man, you know, the 144,000, they're going to be out here sighing and crying, all right? They're going to be teaching this word.
Now, y'all brother has to speak up.
All right? Keep that power, brother.
Bring this over.
All right.
All right, this is Proverbs.
Keep that power.
This is Proverbs, chapter 30, verse 4.
All right. Yeah. Read the scripture.
Let's be loud, brother.
We gotta be loud, brother. Proverbs. This is Proverbs. Chapter 30, verse 4. And it reads, Who has ascended up into heaven?
So the scripture said, who have ascended up into heaven? Keep going.
Or descended,
alright?
Who have gathered the wind in his fist? Who have bound the waters in a garment? Who have bound the garments in a water? And who have bound the waters in a garment? Who have established all the ends of the earth? All
right, keep going.
What is his name? And what is his son's name, if thou canst tell?
So the Lord said, what is his name? All right, the father's name. And what is the son's name, if thou canst tell? All right? So the men of the Lord that Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah had woke up through the Spirit, all right, he gave them that wisdom and knowledge and understanding to come out here to the highways and byways to let our people know that they are the children of Israel and let them know that the Heavenly Father's name is Yahweh and the son's name is Yahweh Shah and that Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah is going to bring destruction upon America. All right? Because America is spiritually Babylon the Great. Bring it up, brother.
This is 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 6. It says, how be it we speak wisdom among them that are perfect. Alright? We speak wisdom among them that are perfect, the ones that are going to be able to obtain all this knowledge, wisdom, and understanding of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah. It says, yet not the wisdom of this world, nor of the princes of this world that come to naught.
Because in these times, alright, the men of the Lord is not going to be of this world. Alright, they're not going to be of this system, man. Alright, keep going, brother.
Alright, it says, but we speak the wisdom of Yahweh in a mystery, right? Even the hidden wisdom which Yahweh ordained before the world unto our glory.
So we speak the word in a mystery, alright? Because these scriptures was written in parables, alright? The Lord speaks in parables. Somebody get that scripture in Matthew? Alright, Bavakashah, the one which said, is given unto you to know the kingdom, the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, Bavakashah. And somebody can also get that he revealed his secret unto his prophets. All right, so in these times, all right, the Lord raised up his prophets to understand the mysteries to come out here to the highways and byways to teach our people and let them know that they are the children of Israel. All right, that the Lord is bringing the judgment upon this land, America, which is spiritually Babylon the Great. All right, judgment is coming. Whoever get it first, bring it up.
Come. Which none of the princes of this world knew, for had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory.
God, so if our people knew that Yahweh Shai was on the scene, they wouldn't crucify our Lord. Alright, that's why 2/3 of our people say, raise it. He's not our king, Caesar our king. Because they didn't know, but only the disciples that the Lord have chose and taught them the words, and they later on became apostles and taught unto faithful men. Alright, keep going.
But as it is written, I have not seen nor ear heard, neither have entered into the hearts of man the things which Yahweh has prepared for them that love him.
So the
ones that's going to love them in these times is the elect, the 144,000 men. All right, the 12,000, the 144,000 men of the tribes of Israel, the 12 tribes, man. All right, and the remnant, one-third women and children. All right, so the Lord, he got his prophets. It's finished.
5 minutes.
5 minutes. The Lord got his prophets amongst his people right now, but they so blind, all right, spiritually in that spiritually Gentile state of mind, going about their day and not really hearing the voice. All right, his voice is out here amongst the people, but they're not hearing it. But only the few is going to hear it. That's why he said, my sheep shall hear my voice. All right? So when the Lord said, two or more gather my name, I'm in the midst of them. So right now, the Lord is in the midst of his people. But they going on in life with celebrating Memorial Day. But in the Bible, the Lord said his name should be a memorial forever forever to all generations, man.
Did you want that scripture to see?
You can bring it up.
I'll hold it for a minute. That's crazy.
She watch.
No, I just thought about it. That's crazy.
John 10:25.
Come.
Yahushua answered them.
Shalak. You can start off a verse up.
Yeah, come. 24. What? Then came the Jews round about him and said unto him, how long doest thou make us to doubt?
Because when the Lord was on the scene, his own people doubted him, did not receive him. All right? He said he came unto his own, and his own did not receive him. Yeah. When the Lord was on the scene, his own people, 2,000 people, didn't receive him. Like they're not receiving him to this now. All right? Because the Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans are the biblical Israelites. All right? The Lord sent his prophets out here to teach unto his people.
26. Actually, 24. How long doest thou make us to doubt? If thou be the Messiah, tell us plainly. Yahushua answered them, I told you, and ye believe me not.
So right now, he's telling them again his men. All right, starting with all the way down, man. So he's telling them now, and they still don't believe. But only a remnant in the elect believe. All right? And Lord willing, we pray that we are part of the elect. That's why we're out here teaching this word.
The works that I do in my Father's name, they bear me witness.
Come on, because the Lord came in his Father's name, not of himself, right? The whole Trinity doctrine is off, right?
But ye believe not, because ye are not of my sheep,
all right,
as
so
I said unto you.
So right now, our people still don't believe that they are the children of Israel, right? The Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, right? Because we are the children of Israel. We are the real princes and kings and our princesses, man. All right, keep going.
My sheep hear my voice.
All right, so the Lord said his sheep hear his voice. Just how right now. You listen to his voice right now. All right, keep going.
I know them, and they follow me.
So the Lord said he knows them, and they follow him. Like right now, through the Spirit. All right, we following the Lord. All right, starting with all the way down. All right, because he is that good shepherd. All right, a shepherd guide his sheep, and we are considered the sheep. Keep going.
And I give unto them eternal life.
Come on, so if you believe on his name, all right, you follow out the examples that he has set before he left the earth. All right, he's going to give us eternal life by believing, having faith. All right, coming out here presenting our bodies as a living sacrifice to teach this word. All right.
And I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall any man pluck them out of my Father's hand.
No man cannot pluck us out of the Father's hand unless Yahweh wants us. All right?
Right.
So therefore, the Lord said, man, we're going to reign with him for 1,000 years, Lord willing, we are part of the elect.
Right. What it say?
No man shall, no. What it say? You be able to change the mind of the gainsayers.
No one can move one of them.
Yeah, like this.
God,
yeah.
Thank
you.
They can't move one of his faith.
Right.
They can't move. They can't take neither one of us.
I hear you, brother.
From out of God's hand.
Nothing. If you become one of the fingers, you're the hand.
Look. If
yeah,
someone's
got to
move,
now, yeah.
He's sovereign. He's sovereign.
Yeah, brother.
He controls all things, not just this world, but all these worlds.
The world.
Can't no one move one finger. You know, you try to bend somebody's fingers, like try to bend one of my fingers.
Yeah.
You can take one, you can bend one, open
easy.
One of my fingers.
Yeah.
But you can't do that to the Most High of God.
No, I couldn't do that to a damn gorilla.
That's
you know what I'm saying?
They got a strength.
They got
a strength.
How the hell?